I had asked for your review for revision exercises. More or less, everyone wanted a revision on editing and omission. So, in this lecture, I will try to make it clearer by explaining the rules once again. Please pay attention and follow the lecture for better scores. I hope you are becoming familiar with my way of teaching. And I look forward to more such reviews so that I can give you better lectures and help you to score much better than what your performance is right now. Right? So you move on. What are the rules for editing and omission? We have already discussed it once, and this time this is just going to show you the highlights of the rules that have been discussed. There are no specific rules for editing and omission. However, we should have a strong foundation in certain areas of grammar to score good marks in this exercise. The errors and mistakes will be found in the following concepts. Now we are going to focus on particular grammar areas that will help you to identify the errors in editing and omission, and you will be able to write your answers confidently. What are our focus points? Let us see. The first one we should take care of is a subject-verb agreement. Singular subjects must have singular verbs, is, am, was, and s form of the verb. Plural subjects must have plural verbs like are, were, and base form of the verb. Now, what do I mean? These are the rules. And so, what do I mean? Let us look at it in our next portion. Singular subjects and singular verbs. He is determined. He is singular and is determined to get the award for the best oration. So, singular subject and singular verb. I am going to the library to borrow a book. So, am, I have already highlighted in my last portion. I am is singular verb for singular subject I. My father works in a firm. So, my father works, work is the verb, and adding s to it, it makes it singular verb. So, for singular subject, singular verb has to be used. We are moving on. For plural subjects, plural verb. My classmates love PE time. Love is the base form of the verb love. So, we are using plural verb with plural subjects. My batchmates are the members of my team. Batchmates are plural. So the plural form of the verb is, we are using as are. So that is why plural subjects go with plural verbs. We move on. Wrong use of preposition. Next portion that is to be taken care of is wrong use of preposition. So what is preposition? Position of noun. So that also has to be carefully looked into in your editing omission question. It is very wrong. It is also wrong to use a preposition when it is unnecessary. Unnecessary use of preposition should be avoided. The prepositions highlighted in bold, I have highlighted the prepositions in bold, are unnecessary and should be avoided. I ordered 10 copies of the book. I ordered 10 copies of the book. 4 is irrelevant or unnecessary. Similarly, he violated against the law of the state. He violated the law of the state. Against is unnecessary here. The committee investigated into the politician's assassination. So into is also irrelevant, unnecessary. the CEO entered into the boardroom. The CEO entered the boardroom. Please sign on this bond. Please sign this bond. Please sign this bond. Can you explain about how a blog is written? Can you explain how a blog is written? So you have seen the unnecessary use of prepositions. More will be easy to understand once we start doing the exercises. And I will be uploading the exercises at the end of the lecture. So you will practice and you will get a free hand on the use of the correct editing omission rules. We are moving on. Determiners and articles. Now comes another important focus point, that is determiners and articles. A countable noun is always preceded by a determiner, like a, an, the, or another determiner. I ate an, the, your apple. I ate an apple. I ate the apple. Or I ate your apple. Not, we cannot write I ate apple. Right. So there is something missing here. So I have to insert the right word using the right determiner. Right. So we move on. I believe you are liking the lecture because I am just giving you the overview. Otherwise you will not be able to take in a continuous lecture. If I am keeping on my lecture to be a lengthy one, you will not be able to follow a lengthy lecture. So I am keeping it short and to the point. In case if you are not able to follow, you will have to ask me back. Right. No article is used with plural and uncountable nouns. With plural nouns, we are not using any article. A and the whatever. Right. And uncountable nouns also. Here plural I have highlighted in red. So the plural noun also is in red. Movies are my favorite way to relax. I have not mentioned the movies. So without article, the movies are my favorite way to relax. Similarly, uncountable noun is in blue. And I have mentioned the noun also in blue in the sentence. I think that honesty is important. So here I think that no article to be used, honesty is important, right? Conjunctions. Now I have already discussed with my oratory club about the fanboys. So I'm discussing with my whole class now, what is fanboys standing for? Very useful to remember conjunctions. F stands for. Most of the visitors were tired, for the journey had been too long. So here, when I am using for, whenever I am trying to explain why, I am using for. F stands for fanboys. F-A-N-B-O-Y-S stands for fanboys. Right. And so we are going to do it one by one. Most of the visitors were tired, for, F stands for the journey had been too long. Whenever I'm trying to explain why. So similarly, another sentence we can think of, he is overweight, for he eats too many cakes and biscuits. So explaining why. And goes with A. He ate a sandwich and French fries. So when do I use and? And is used to connect the last item of a serial list. What do I mean? If supposing two independent sentences are there, or two independent clauses are there. He ate a sandwich. He ate French fries. So he ate two things. The list is containing two items. So if I am wanting to club or to join the two items, I use and. So anytime, whenever I am wanting to join two items in a cereal, I am using and. He ate a sandwich and French fries. So A stands for and. Then comes N. He is neither sane nor brilliant. So nor, N stands for nor. He is neither sane nor brilliant. It is commonly used as the little brother in the correlative pair, like neither nor, or not, like he is neither sane nor brilliant. So whenever you are using neither, you have to use nor. Or look at this sentence, he doesn't eat cake nor does he eat biscuits. So not is there twice, so I have to be very careful. What am I using? Am I using the right conjunction or not? I do not like cake, nor do I like biscuits. So not, nor. Okay, and neither, nor. Both taken, nor. Moving on to B. B stands for but. He wanted to buy an ice cream, but he didn't have any money. So when am I using but? When two independent clauses are connected. My dear children, what are independent clauses? Independent clauses are those sentences or those clauses that can stand by themselves, right? They do not need any other supporting sentence to stand or any other supporting clause to stand. Right, so he wanted to buy an ice cream. If I'm using it as one clause, he didn't have any money. That can be used also as another clause. So two independent clauses, both are independent clauses, and we want to join these two independent clauses together. That time I'm using but. So he wanted to buy an ice cream, but he didn't have money. I eat cake, but I never eat biscuits. So I am showing that two independent clauses can be joined together with but. O stands for or. Whenever I am trying to suggest another possibility, that time I have to use or. It's hard to say whether this or that is better. Right, another possibility is there. So that time I'm using or. So would you like cake or biscuits with your coffee? So possibility, that is why or is used. Why stands for yet. He writes well, yet his favorite passion is reading. To show contrast or opposite ideas, I am using why in fanboys. So why here stands for yet. To show contrast in opposite ideas. Here I have tried to explain. He writes well, yet his favorite passion is reading. Two opposite ideas. Can you see? And then another sentence I can share with you. Another example. So many questions, yet so few answers. So questions are many, answers are few. So that time also I'm using yet. So two opposite or contrasting ideas are when they are connected. Now I'm moving on to the last one, that is S, and it stands for so. It was raining, so we brought an umbrella. So whenever I'm trying to explain another why, sometimes I'm using so. It was raining, so we brought an umbrella. So another sentence, he was very hungry, so he ate all the cake. Another explanation, conjunction that we are using to explain why. With more practice, obviously the confidence will become better day by day. We are going to have some more exercises, and I am sure you are going to be masters, you know, children, simply masters in your editing omission, right? We are moving on to the last portion, that is tense. After reading the passage, identify the tense, children, whether it is simple present tense, past tense, and future tense, whether any of these tenses or a part of these tenses. Please identify the tense and try to insert the right tense according to the editing omission asked for, right? So that is all. So we are going to do some assignments, some exercises, and I am sure you will feel better and confident with the completion of these exercises, right? All the best. Have a nice day, children. Love you all. Hello? Yes, children. Love you all. Thank you.